So I searched for videos on YouTube on how to remove the handles on this Dometic fridge. And to my no avail, I ended up finding absolutely nothing. So I'm making this video today to show you guys how to do this. This is my 2021 Winnebago bunkhouse model, and I will talk about my lighting in another video. But right now, I'm going to explain to you how I removed this handle that was broken and replaced it, because it's a little tricky. They send you the parts, but they don't send you the directions on how to do it. So my light here is blown, and I've read that these bulbs keep blowing on people. So I just have an LED light that's rechargeable through USB that I use there instead. Basically, this is the part number for the Dometic. I guess you guys can always call and find out and make sure it's the same handle for your fridge. But what happened was, from day one, the door was actually really hard to open. And we would have to pull it like this and work it quite a few times. And one day, my son just cranked it like that, and the plastic broke. Now, why these are plastic, I have no idea. To make the trailer lighter, maybe? I don't know. They should be metal. But the plastic broke over here. So I tried duct taping it, and I tried using glue, tried putting it back together. See, it's cracked all in there. And that didn't work. So what I needed to do was replace the whole thing. I called Dometic. They were nice enough to send me out a new handle and this little piece that goes at the top. Now, this piece is important because this piece here is that little piece. When I was trying to take off the other handle, I didn't know how to do it, and I ended up breaking this piece here. So I asked them if they could send me a replacement, and that's what it looked like. So I was dumbfounded when I saw this thing. I'm like, okay, I'm female. I don't know what this is. I don't know how to do this. So what I did was I unscrewed that screw there and then unscrewed these screws and took my handle out. When you unscrew this, there will be a little hole in there, okay? And this piece here is what happened to mine. So that also broke. So you can see it's in two pieces here when it should look like that. And mine is definitely not looking like that. So what I needed to do was basically unscrew that. Then you have to wedge it out. So I wedged it out and then popped it out. But before I could do that, this needed to come off. Actually, no, I didn't have to take that part off first, but you can to make it easier to get it out. So I popped it out. Then, in order to get the handle on, which they don't give you directions on how to do it, so what you need to do is you need to pop this up with a knife, pop up the corners there. Don't fully pop it out because it will break. You don't fully remove it. You just pop it up and move it out the way a little bit so that you can slide these corners here. There's little grooves here that need to go into the fridge. So you can see here, there's one there, one here, and another one there. So you need to basically get that in between the door here. And it's impossible to do it, to slide it in and try it like that, because I tried. And then I'm like, okay, there's got to be another way to do this. So after trial and error, I figured out, just pop that part up, pull that piece out, then you'll be able to slide it down from the top. You just hold the handle like this, make your way in from the bottom one right there, slide it in, and then it'll just slide right down. And there you have it, onto your piece. Then what you can do is pop this piece back in. So all you need to do is push it in this way, and then it'll go back on. Put your screws on, pop that down, pop these two screws on, and voila, your new handle is installed. So this one is much easier to open. It doesn't get stuck like the other one. The other one kept getting stuck and I couldn't open my fridge. So this one, I just have to go like that and slightly and it opens. So I'm hoping it stays like that and hoping that I don't have any other issues opening and closing this, but I'm gonna have to teach the kids how to do it properly. The freezer opens nicely. I don't have any issues with the freezer. So that's it. That's my Dometic. And this is the fridge that I have. It's the, it doesn't say the name, but I don't know the size of it, but that's the part number anyways that they gave me. All you have to do is call Dometic and give them your information and they will send you out the proper parts. Thank you for watching my video.